start with the 46th example and what is said here. A solid body rotates about a stationary axis where the position, angular position is at minus bt cube, where the value of a is given to us 6 and b is given to us 2 t cube, like this. Find the mean value of angular velocity. So first of all, angular velocity at any time t will be derivative of angular position with respect to time. So it will be derivative of 6 t minus 2 3 the whole cube. Now derivative 6 as it is, derivative of t with respect to t will be 1, 2 as it is, and derivative of t raised to 3 will be 3 t square. So it will be 6 minus 6 t square. This is angular velocity at any time t. Angular acceleration at any time t will be derivative of angular velocity with respect to time. So that would be the derivative of 6 minus 6 t square. So first, the derivative of 6 is 0, it's constant, minus 6 as it is. Derivative of t square would be 2t. So angular acceleration at any time t will be equal to 12t. Now what is asked? We need to find the value of angular velocity and angular acceleration, the mean value, that is average value, from t is equal to 0 to the time when it stops. So we need to find the time when the angular velocity is getting stopped by substituting, say this is equation 1, this is equation 2, and this is equation 3. By substituting omega 0 in equation 2, so it will be 6 minus 6 t square equal to 0. So 6 is equal to 6 t square. So t square will be equal to 1, so t comes out to be plus or minus 1 second. So that is 0 to 1 second, because at t is equal to 1 second, the body gets stopped. So now I can say the average angular velocity or the mean angular velocity is nothing but final angular position at 1 second minus angular position at t equal to 0 second divided by time interval, that is 0 to 1 second is 1 second, substitute. So angular velocity at 1 second will be 6 into 1 minus 2 into 1 cube minus 0 divided by 1. So that comes out to be 6 minus 2, so that would be 4 radian per second, and that is the angular acceleration. Now the average angular velocity will be equal to, again, angular velocity at 1 second minus angular velocity at 0 second divided by time interval 1 minus 0. So angular velocity at 1 second, by substituting the value in equation 2, 6 minus 6 into 1 square, angular velocity at 1 second can be found. Angular velocity at 0 second, 6 minus 6 into 0 ka square divided by time interval 1 minus 0. So the average angular acceleration comes out to be 6 minus 6 minus 6 minus 0 upon 1. So 6 minus 6 is 0, so it will be minus 6 radian per second square. That is the average angular velocity in that interval. So this is the answer to the A part of the question. Now the angular acceleration at the moment when body stops. Okay, no problem. So the B part. So angular acceleration when body stops, that is angular acceleration at 1 second is how much? So angular acceleration at t second is minus 12 into t. So angular acceleration at 1 second will be minus 12 into 1. So angular acceleration at 1 second comes out to be minus 12 radian per second square, and that's the answer to this question. Thank you.